evening to all the educators. I extend a very warm welcome on behalf of Team Madhuban to all the participants who have joined us for this panel discussion today. Today, we look forward to understand some of the best practices to ensure the smooth functioning of the online learning along with integration of experiential learning into this system so that learning becomes effective, engaging, and everlasting.
Visited a school for an interaction with students of class 11, right? Probably you might have heard about this, that after my interaction with students, one student asked me a question there, and I considered it to be a very silly question. He asked me, sir, where do you buy your milk, right? I was shocked because that was not relevant. Then he insisted on me saying the answer. So I immediately said, I buy it from the milk shop. Then he asked me, where do you buy your drugs? I said, I buy it from the chemist shop. Then he said, where do you buy your cosmetics? I said, I buy it from the nearest mall. I asked him, why are you asking me? Sir, if you can buy different things in different places, why should I go to the same school for physics, chemistry, and biology? Can I go to one school for physics, one for chemistry, and one for biology? That is what is called the future of learning, learning by choice.
So there's a lot of fundamental change happening in education. You know, we've been trying to gauge it for the last 10 years or even more, you know, more time. And we've not really been able to lay our fingers on it. Because each time what happened is when a challenge came to us, we rushed back to our textbooks and the question and answer method. And slowly and gradually, you know, this knowledge society emerged. You know, use this opportunity that COVID-19 has provided to us. And with this, I think both teachers and students are going to learn new methods, they're going to learn new skills, and also going to invite the digital age.
Teacher-led methods that are being used in our schools, because it's been kind of forced down on us. We haven't been prepared for this kind of a scenario. The whole world has been taken aback, honestly. So it's very important that from this teacher-led method, gradually our teachers need to work around and see how they can shift the onus of learning to the students in the online platform. So more of flipped classrooms can be brought in, more of using the children's prior experiences, using the children's prior knowledge to build on the new learning. All that methodology that we were already doing in the classrooms now needs to be brought in more into the online methods to make it more realistic.